Noise-cancelling headphones are more popular than ever, and that means there's more choice than ever. Every day I get sent new pairs to review, and I've chosen three of the best. We've got the Bose QuietComfort 35 Mark II, the Sony WH-1000X M2, and the Bowers & Wilkins PX. If isolation is important to you, if you want the very best noise cancelling there is, then you'll want the Bose, because they are by far the best at blocking everybody out. We're talking traffic noise, plane engine sounds, people chattering in the office. It turns every noise you can hear out there into pretty much a whisper. They're also really comfortable, so they live up to the whole quiet comfort branding. They're the lightest here, they're plastic, but that's no bad thing because it means that when you wear them for long periods of time, they're not really going to be very tiring. Features-wise, they're a little basic. Bose has just added the smart button here, which handles Google Assistant. Basically, it's a way of integrating Google Assistant into your listening experience. So if you've got text messages or emails, you can tap that and it'll read it out to you. If you don't like Google Assistant or if you don't need it, then you can use the app to turn that button into an adjustment for noise cancelling. So you can have noise cancelling on, off, or medium. As for sound quality, they're pretty good. They're not the best there is, but they're more than good enough for most people. They're very clear, there's no hiss or whine from the wireless element of it, and there's a nice smooth performance that makes it a very easy listen. For the best sound quality, I would choose the Bowers & Wilkins PX. That's because of the company's hi-fi heritage. They really know a thing or two about sound. It's simply the finest, most detailed performance that you have here. And Bowers & Wilkins headphones used to be a little bit too warm, too rich for my liking, but they've toned back the bass a little bit. And so overall, you've got a really natural performance that's just full of detail and subtlety. Noise cancelling quality isn't the best though. It's good, but out of the three of these are not the strongest. They'll be fine for office use and blocking out the engines on a plane, but if you want to shut out entire chatter on tube trains or train announcements, you'll probably still hear those a little bit. The Bowers & Wilkins also have the most premium design. If you look at the Bose and the Sony, they're primarily plastic. I mean, there's a bit of synthetic leather here, but these feel really luxurious. You've got anodized aluminium on the ears and the headband. You've got ballistic nylon in the ear cups, real sheepskin leather, I believe, on the ear cups and headband. They're not loaded with features, but there is one thing that I really like, and that's the automatic sensors that you have in the ear cups. Basically, they know when you put them on, and they'll automatically power up and connect to your phone. So you could technically go for days without touching the power button. You can leave them on the side and they'll go into low power mode, pick them up, put them on, and they'll automatically start playing. It's that simple. You can turn that feature off in the app. The app also lets you adjust various levels of noise cancelling. So if you don't want total silence, if you want to let in some voices, the app can do that too. Finally, we have the Sony, and they are sort of a really good middle ground. They're not the very best at noise cancelling, but they're more than good enough. They're better than the Bowers. They're not the very best at musical performance, but again, more than good enough. You've got a really agile sound, very punchy, very dynamic, very entertaining, better than the Bose in that department, not quite as detailed as the Bowers. Design-wise, they're also kind of halfway. It's not as luxurious as the Bowers and Wilkins, but it's a little more interesting than the slightly plasticky Bose. You've got some metal elements on the headband, mostly plastic everywhere, synthetic leather on the ear cups, and it feels nice. For £330, which is the same as the Bose, you do feel like you get better value for money from the design. The headline feature is adaptive noise cancelling. Now, we've been able to adjust levels of noise cancelling for a while now, so you can go from on, off, medium, but these do it for you. They connect to an app on your phone, and they'll use your phone's accelerometer to decide what you're doing. So if you're sitting still in an office, they'll let in some voices so you can hear your colleagues. If you start walking, they'll let in some general ambient sound so you don't get run over. If you get on a train or a plane, they'll know as well, and it will go ping and turn the noise cancelling up to full, blocking everything else out. It sounds like a gimmick, but it actually works, and it's really, really useful. The Sonys also have the best battery life. The Bose and Bowers & Wilkins both do around up to 20 hours, whereas you can perform wirelessly with the Sonys for up to 30. As for price, they're all around £330, which pretty much is the going rate if you want the best noise-cancelling headphones out there. Overall, if I had to take home a pair, I would choose the Sony because they're the best all-rounders here. They have almost as good a sound quality as Bowers & Wilkins. The noise cancelling is almost as good as the Bose. The smart features with the adaptive noise cancelling is genuinely useful, and they've got the best battery life. For the money, it's got to be the Sony. So there you have it. For more headphone reviews, check out trustedreviews.com.